Okay.
Sorry, yeah, we have to enable that.
Majority, you know, creating TV commercials, doing brand photo shoots, branding marketing exercises, and, you know, social media, and so celebrity collaborations, and doing a lot of stuff. Started working with television first, then moved to advertising. And now I'm using all of that knowledge to put in AI, and I'm serving the industry again with a new tool, which is artificial intelligence. Now, when I say AI, there are, of course, we know that there are so many different tools now. There is for image, for text, for music, for audio, for speech, and everything, for text to video. I mean, text to video, I mean, personally, is a big game changer now. And in the future, it's going to prove as a bigger game changer than image generation platforms, because social media has a wider reach for video, as we all know, because reels are getting more view than still images. So even if your art is like really amazing, your picture looks beautiful, the video is going to get more attention on social media. So from practical point of view also, videos, if the day AI will start spitting out better videos, it's going to kill a lot of things, is what my personal prediction is. So that's what my background is, and that's what I've been doing. I think I would like to share my screen and share my presentation. It's like a very small deck I have, just to keep the conversation in track.
Tapan, one quick request. Can you be slightly louder so that there's I think some echo, so probably we are not able to hear you clearly.
Okay.
Slight loud will be better.
Okay. Let me know if it's better. Is it better now?
Yeah, relatively better. Yes.
Better. Okay. I'll be a bit louder now.
Thank you.
So sharing my screen here. Just let me know once you can see my screen, brother. Can everyone else?
Yeah, we can see.
All right. So reimagining art with AI is the title I've given for this event, for this session, because.
A quick request for everyone to kindly make sure they're on mute. Thank you.
Yeah. So I'll begin with the very, very basic question that I've been asked multiple times. And I think that's also a very big discussion that is happening all over the internet, that is AI art really an art? I'm pretty sure we all would have come across this question at some point. Whoever is working with Midjourney or Stable Diffusion or any other software they're working, I'm sure Pratik also would have come across this question multiple times, that is AI art actually an art? He would have probably seen also. I would personally say it is definitely an art. Why? Because what makes anything an art and what makes anyone an artist? A process makes you an artist. A process where there are tools involved, where there are internal questions are involved, there's a journey involved, where you self-discover, where you are trying to express yourself, and you are seeking tools which will let you express yourself and give visual to your thought. Now, if it's a paintbrush, or if it's a camera, or if it's a Photoshop, or you're using a Wacom, or you're using Procreate on iPad, or whatever you're using, you are expressing yourself, you are trying to give visual to your thought, and you are trying to let the world inside your head flow outside. That's what art means. Now, it can be on canvas, it can be through clay, or it can be through paper mache, or the material can be anything. As long as a medium is letting you express your thought, it is definitely an art. The form evolves, the form keeps changing. Every decade, every 5 years, every year, form changes. When cameras were involved, we as a humanity went through the same argument. That is photography and art. Because before that, people who used to paint were only called artists. That okay, if you have to carry your canvas to mountain, you have to mount it there, you have to have paintbrush, and then you have to paint the scenery that is in front of you. Then only you are an artist. And then cameras came, and then people started thinking. A lot of people started argumenting that you are not doing anything, you are just clicking a button. How are you an artist? And now that we have AI art, photographers are artists. Why? Because there is a faster medium. So a slower medium looks more legitimate. That's a misconception. So for me, AI is definitely an art because you are expressing. It's just a faster medium, more accurate. If, okay, so during this conversation, if anyone has any question, you can please put it in chat. We will take all the questions during Q&A session during the last 30 minutes. Or you can message Pratik. Pratik can probably keep the track of question, and then both of us can address it. Because I'm sure as I move forward, people would have question over whatever I'm saying. So I would like them to write them in the chat. Creative applications of AI. Now, when I say creative applications, we all are design students. You know, we all have learned what is formal design, what is functional design. We have learned the design that just looks good, the design that is functional, that actually works. The same thing applies to the AI art also. But whatever images you are creating through Midjourney or Dall-E Diffusion, a lot of people say on internet, a lot of people who have interviewed me or who have met, they say that whatever you are creating looks good, looks nice. But that's a very formal approach. Where is the functional approach? If you are creating a chair using Midjourney, is it actually something which I can manufacture? If you're using a building, can you actually create the building that looks good on Instagram? The answer is, for now, there is a cap. For now, it's definitely a bit difficult to translate it in real world, but there are AI tools which let you generate images or which let you design using AI, which is practical. These tools are definitely based on Stable Diffusion's API, because that's the only AI which has open API. So people are using it to build their own products. These tools, I'll be sharing the list of those tools which will help you create functional designs rather formal. Now, when it comes to formal, it is more of an art, and when it comes to functional, it's more of a design. So that's the fundamental difference between art and design. Like art you create for yourself, and design you are doing for someone else. Because art is inner journey, it's for inner satisfaction, and design is definitely for client. So there are tools that let you create art, like Midjourney. It's difficult to expect something out of Midjourney which is practical and like something actually works in real life. Vegetable Diffusion can actually help you create things which are practical because it has better control. I'm sure you would have gotten that exposure in Pratik's prompt mastery class, because he's the one who is building a Gen AI product. So he's a better person to tell you what's the difference between different prompt across platform. Like how one prompt work on Midjourney, the same prompt will work different on Stable Diffusion or Wombo or any other platform. So creative applications of AI are not limited to platforms. There are different platforms which can let you create things for different applications. Comes to AI art tools and platforms. Now, definitely, we all know Midjourney, Stable Diffusion. We all know a lot of. I think Runway is something I didn't see in chat box. But I think is Runway there somewhere? Can you see? I don't see Runways.
No, not a lot. Yeah.
So I think I would like to share a small video that I've created using Runway that would give people a glimpse into generative video. Now the video that I'm going to show is a collection of small videos, and all of them are generated out of text, pure text to video, nothing else there. There are a couple of more tools which I will be showing, but I'll first start with the Runway. So quick response, what do you all think of this video? What can you make out of this video? What are your comments? I just want to hear people's comment on this. What do they think of this?
Can we watch this again? Sorry, I'm
skipping. Sure. Yes, anyone? Okay, I have one comment from Pratik. Okay, Khushbu saying that looks like it would have taken a long time to create. Okay, any assumption how much time it would have taken for me to create this video? Just any wild guess, anyone? The entire video, from all the clip to combining them, putting music, everything end to end, from zero to one. Okay, nice. 5 to 10 minutes. You try it. That means, okay, really glad. I'm really glad that people are really okay. It's cool. Okay. Okay. The monks is saying it's cool, but I'm not seeing usable as ads presentation. That's correct. Absolutely right. This will definitely need more original feels. Yes, 10 minutes if AI made it. 2 to 3 hours. Okay, 3. Okay, someone's saying 3 minutes. Nice. Okay. I think closest is Pratik. It's 2 to 3 hours. 2 to 3 hours because runway is also going to take some time to generate this, render this, and then you upscale it and then you do it. But yes. Just to generate these videos, it definitely took less than an hour to generate all the videos and then, upscaling it and everything. Now, this is the speed we are talking about. We're definitely nowhere close to a final product. We are nowhere close to a video that is production ready or we can upload somewhere. But for now, the only beauty is that AI is able to generate videos out of nothingness, out of absolute zero. So that's a pure beauty. And if you have more artistic approach, you can definitely create videos that are really difficult to shoot or create using traditional platforms. There's one more I would like to show that I created using Kyber. We'll talk about that as well. You would have seen something similar on internet using Stable Diffusion, but this is Kyber. Okay, Shivangi said it's really helpful in quick visualization. That's absolutely correct, Shivangi. It's really helpful. So whenever so many times it has happened that I'm 1 hour away from client meeting or 2 hours away from client meeting, and I really want to generate something quick, a quick video or a quick image for a presentation, or when I'm going for a shoot and I don't have a storyboard to present to my cinematographer. These tools are really a great help to quickly ideate angles. And this runway is really helpful in generating quick videos. the only difficulty currently I'm facing with Runway is the prompt structure in Runway is absolutely different than Stable Diffusion and Midjourney both. So okay, someone is saying, can you talk about how do you make sure you use right prompts? Pratik, Himanshu Methi is saying your video is paused.
No, we're able to see it. I think there was a glitch for a second, but now we can see.
Okay. So Swarada is saying that, can you talk about how do you make sure you use right prompts? It might sound odd, but there is actually no trick to find right prompt. It's a lot of trial and error because these platforms are evolving, their data set is evolving, their algorithm is also evolving. They're changing their code every week, every few days. I'm sure Pratik must be aware of it. And he also must be facing this issue because he's building a product. He must be facing this issue that Stable Diffusion ka code change ho gaya hai, you know, API change ho gaya hai. The same thing is happening with these tools also, that a lot of time you really don't know, if it's the right prompt or wrong. It's a lot of trial error. The more you use platform, the more you understand the language of it. It's exactly like being with a person. The more you stay with that person, the more you understand what kind of language that person understands. Like when you are with your partner, if you are dating someone, you are married, or your family members, the more you stay, or your roommate in hostel, the more you stay, the more you understand, ki isko massive bolunga ki yaar wo bottle wahan rakh de, he will not understand. I'll have to tell a bit more than wo bottle wahan rakh de, ki yaar tu udhar rakh de, varna aisa hoga. Or whatever. So there is a way we talk to a person to get things done. It applies to office, it applies to our colleague, partner, whatever. The same thing. So it's a lot and lot of trial and error. It took me almost a year to get used to Midjourney. So in order to make AI your ally, you actually have to understand the language. One way I would say to make sure that the way that I personally use to make sure that I'm using the right prompt is on Midjourney, I use shorten command a lot. Now shorten is a really helpful command. It's one of the new releases where you give a prompt and Midjourney will actually tell you that what are the word it is going to get emphasized on. So I'll show you the demo of that also. Swarada, are you aware of that tool on that particular thing on Midjourney? I think I'll just wait for an answer and then we will continue.
Tapan, meanwhile, we'd love to see this video, the one that you've shared. Was this entirely AI made? Like the complete rendering of all the... Wow.
Yes, 100%. 100% AI. Okay, Adesh is asking, what are the views in API and usage in building product? I think that's Pratik's expertise. So I would not like to touch the building product part and API. That's not my zone. So I would respectfully pass it to Pratik for to answer. Pratik, would you like to explain the API, API's role and building product?
Sure. So APIs are... Let's put it very simply, these are highways on which information can be exchanged between two or three different softwares or platforms. How the AI ecosystem or world is working right now is you have a model. Now, Midjourney or Stable Diffusion, these are separate AI models. Let's call it separate AI softwares. They are being hosted on an online platform run by some other company. And when you want to use it as a user, you send in some information to them, and that information gets sent on a highway. Let's call that as an API. So you're sending that information and you get all the data back on a similar highway for you to access that. So Midjourney currently does not have APIs. Stable Diffusion does. So a lot of people who are building their own products use these APIs to use the AI model for their own sake. For example, ChatGPT or any of your large language models that you're using, they are all run by some other AI model at the back end, which they are interacting with through these APIs. So these APIs are nothing but means of communication between two platforms or two models. You can quickly read up about it. It's a very simple concept, slightly technical to implement though, but yeah, easy to understand. And the usage prices for each of these models are very different, Adesh, because they're largely dependent on what the company is charging for. For example, something like Midjourney. So they are running their entire sessions on Discord right now. So they have a very different pricing plan as compared to say a Dall-E or a Stable Diffusion or what even say a Runway, which has its own models and its own user interface on top of it. So all these usage pricings are very different. And each company that is coming up with its own model has defined its own usage pricing. So, yeah.
Thank you, Pratik. Thank you. I'll take the next question, which is Manchu Methi's article asking that the starting of the video is also AI. No, that's a real footage I've taken from YouTube. The last frame of this video is the beginning point for the AI to pick from. So if you just see here, I'll just play the video. Yeah, so this is real video. And then it gets paused here. And this particular JPEG is the input that I've given to Kyber. Now this is a video. Till here, this is video. Okay. I took a screenshot of this particular frame on VLC media player or Premiere, whatever. You can use different software to take a screenshot. You take a JPEG of it and then you give it in Kyber. Kyber is a software which will take your image and then evolve shapes out of it. It works on a very beautiful algorithm, which gives you very beautiful this evolving. And the prompt is actually a magic where you're creating. So I tried to create the reverse evolution of automobile. As you must be seeing that here, it's going in past, like it's showing motorcycle in every decade. Of course, you know, factually, this cannot be real. Like this is, if you trace this image, you will not get the exact two-wheeler what it was probably in 1980 or 70. But it's just going to give a feel of it because again, as I mentioned, this is an art and not a functional design tool. But then it's very formal, not functional. So it's going to look good, might be factually incorrect. Okay, so that is Kyber. There is one more, which is Replicate. Now, this video that you are seeing is entirely generated out of text. This is pure text to video, and so is this. Just look at the finesse. They're very, very less anomaly and fishish. Very less distortion. You can feel it's underwater. The coral has a very nice texture on it. So Runway is quite expensive. Definitely Runway is more refined, but sometimes I feel that this free. Now this tool, Replicate, is absolutely free. These free tools are, I think, you know, a lot of time generating better videos than paid tools. There is one more called Pika Labs, recently got released. And there is something called Full Journey. Full Journey is giving 10 seconds of video generation. Full Journey is actually, I really didn't want to mention the name Full Journey here, but somehow I did. But see, Full Journey is a very nasty model that's been trained on a lot of wrong data set. Personally, I would not recommend someone using Full Journey because it's been trained on unethical data set. A lot of NSFW content people create on Full Journey. The only reason Full Journey is useful is it gives 10 seconds of video generation, where something like Replicate is only giving 1 second of video generation. Pika Labs is giving 4 seconds. Runway is giving somewhere around 3 to 4 seconds. So Full Journey is the only model that gives 10 seconds of video. But I would not recommend anyone opening it in college computer. Harshit sir, please make sure people don't access Full Journey in college. It's been trained on a lot of unethical data. I just stumbled upon that software through a WhatsApp group. There's a Gen AI WhatsApp group where people keep sharing these new innovations and new discoveries. So I came to know about that. It's a free server, but people are absolutely misusing it. Okay, this is an interesting part. This is an interactive demo. We will try to create some interesting prompt and we'll try to create some beautiful image. I think I would like to have people's participation in this. I would really love people to participate. There's an interesting thing I have. I have an old dice. We will roll a dice. Whatever number comes, we will think of a word. जिसमें उतने ही लेटर होंगे यू थिंक ऑफ अ वर्ड विद 3 लेटर्स और 5 और 6 ओके सो आई एम गोइंग टू रोल अ डाइस एंड फर्स्ट पर्सन टू कमेंट अ वर्ड विद इन दैट कैरेक्टर लिमिट आई विल टेक दैट वर्ड आई विल पुट इट इन मिडजर्नी वी विल सी व्हाट वी क्रिएट वी ऑल नो हाउ दिस वर्क्स बट इट्स अ फन एक्सरसाइज आई एम गोइंग टू रोल अ डाइस ओके चैट रेडी गुड इट्स अ गुड हेड्स अप प्रतीक Whoa, okay, it's one. Who's going to give me a one single character? Ah, okay, Swarada, thanks. Okay, I'll say, sorry. Okay. Okay, I'm going to roll again. Oh shit, it's again. Okay, I think I'm going to skip. I'll roll one more time. Three, okay, three letter word. A pet, thanks Shruti. A pet, okay. A new pet fan. Pratik, should we go with all three? New pet fan.
Whatever floats the boat, Tapan.
A new pet fan. I'll put a comma there. No, I'm not doing one again. Five. Okay. Five letter word. That's four. Okay. Friend. A new pet fan. Friend. Night mango ghost. Okay. I think Midjourney is going to shut down. Night mango ghost. I'll put a comma again. Six. Okay. Six letter word. circus. Nice. Please. Oh wow. Oh wow. Okay. Okay. We'll give some new people also chance. I'm seeing a lot of usual players. I'm really sorry. I'll skip you guys and I'll move to Neha and Chenali this time. Candle wait. Okay. I think this is a good prompt to begin with. A new pet friend will put with friend in night. Eating mango with a ghost under candle with wait. Let's see. We'll put it 4x5, so it's now we just let it be square. Let's see. We'll put a stylized to 250 and we'll put chaos to 25. We'll put weird 200.
So Tapan would love to understand what is this stylized, chaos, weird, all of these. Like we did prompting, but we did large language model prompting, not the generative art prompting. So would love to understand this. This is something new to me as well.
Sure. Okay. I'm pretty sure this will get sold as NFT at a really good price. Okay. Can anyone see the weight of their prompt particularly? Then we'll see how to put weight. Did you guys try putting weight with the prompt, Pratik, the other day?
Tapan, I've never generated images. We only do large language model prompting for text output.
Okay.
So I am as new as the newest person in this group and I am equally mesmerized by this.
Okay. So see, you see a lot of things really work, a lot of didn't work. Now we'll address Swarada's question that she asked earlier about how do we know that the prompt is correct, right? I'll go to shorten. You select this prompt, you neglect all the arguments. Okay, so by the way, the S, C, weird, and V, they are called arguments. We will let go of those arguments and we'll only take the text part. We copy it here, we'll hit enter. Okay, we say show details. Midjourney will show you how much weight it has put on each word of the prompt. For the better thing, I'm going to zoom in for everyone to see. The Midjourney actually put more weight on pet. The lesser weight was being put on eating. Then mango, friend, candle, fan, night, and under. In ascending order. Midjourney is also going to give you a shortened prompt, which Midjourney thinks would also work for you if you want to get similar result. So you can keep checking your prompts with this command. Midjourney will tell you what actually matters to it and what doesn't matter. There are a few words in the prompt that is like, for example, ghost. Now it is saying that a ghost, it didn't understand ghost. Okay, I'm really sorry. My spelling, okay, my ghost ka spelling galat. I'm really sorry. But then somehow we are seeing that ghosty effect though. We are not seeing the ghost. So it has not created the gimmicky, cartoony image of ghost. Like we see that white drapes, maybe see a ghost. So it is not created because it clearly mentioned here that Midjourney really didn't consider ghost as a word in the prompt. The word that it actually took is pet. So we can really see pets here. We can see we can say, I don't know, I'm really sorry. Okay, we see cat, we see dog, we see this, we see raccoon. Is this a raccoon?
Probably close to something like that.
It's I think it's King Julian in Madagascar. I don't know what animal, but it's definitely King Julian from Madagascar. And then we have a hedgehog. So it understood pet, and then eating is a second word that it put emphasis on. So we see all of them eating here. Then there is mango. We definitely see a mango here, somewhere here. We see something which looks like mango. So yeah, as I mean, this is I hope I've answered your question, Swarada. Would you like to play this game one more time? Anybody? I want to move on to something else.
I mean, I'd love to play this, but can we generate some sort of an advertisement? This is very interesting, yes.
I didn't understand.
Or some product. Let's make it for some product, maybe.
Okay. Okay, sorry. Before moving on, I will talk about the arguments here. All the arguments that we have. So let's say you want to create a chair. So talking about product, let's start with a wooden chair. Let's say a wooden chair, and we will see an image of a wooden chair here. This is one more thing that is going to be very difficult in future for people to pursue AI art as the only form of art, because to generate beautiful images is becoming increasingly easy. Now, if I compare this to what used to get generated a year back, I started using Midjourney somewhere around Feb or March 2022. That time, if you had to create something like this, it would take at least 11 to 12 words in a prompt. You have to say so many things, and then you have to put so many arguments at the end to generate something like this. It's mesmerizing that only wooden chair is giving you such stylized outputs now. But then if you don't want this, and if you just want a simple wooden chair, so now to create simpler thing has become more difficult. More fancier things have become easier, because the models are more stylized now, you know, it's been tuned to be more stylized. So the argument called S, you know, has a very different meaning now. So let's say we say wooden chair, and we put, so S is stylized. Higher the value, more stylized the image is. Now to have it stylized, we also have to have a couple of words which will give it style. Now we say wooden chair in Mondrian style. Let's say we give it Mondrian style. Okay, and then we say colorful, we say 3D. Now let's set style value to 250. We'll copy the prompt and we'll keep increasing it. Or let's say we start with 50, not 50, actually the base is 100, so we'll start with 150. Okay, we start with 150. We copy the same prompt and we do 250. We copy the value can go all the way till 1000. I don't think it can go more than 1000. So for 250, we'll say 750. And after 750, we'll say 1000. So the higher the value, more stylized the image. So here we have style value 150. Now we all know what Mondrian style is. And so Mondrian style has been incorporated and the stylized value has been set to 150. If you increase it to 250, you see it's more stylized. If you increase it to, sorry, here it's 750. 750, it's even more stylized. And then 1000. So this is style value 1000 and this is 150. So you have to keep playing with S value a lot. If you want something more stylized or less stylized, you can also put a value under 100 if you want it very, very simple, very plain. You can just say stylized 50. Yeah. So I took the value under 100. So it simplified it. It simplified it to a level that it looked like a very normal, basic wooden chair. So that's what a value of S can really do to your picture. From 50 to 1000, there's an entire range in between you can play to decide the stylized value. Now let's say we go with 750, or let's say we go with 500. I think 500 is a good spot. We'll go with 500 and we will add one more argument, which is called chaos. So it's hyphen C. And hyphen C is chaos. What chaos really does is, higher the chaos value, more difference it will create in all four variations. So if you say chaos 10, there is less variation in all four images. The higher the value, the more variation. Now let's say we say chaos 50. We are keeping the stylized value same and we are just playing with chaos. Here we say chaos 100. So all four images will be absolutely different than each other. This is a great tool for ideation. Whenever we are ideating and you really don't know what shape you're looking for. If you are creating a character, you're creating a background or a product or whatever you are creating, chaos value is going to give you absolutely different four options. Is everyone with me here? Everyone is in sync. If I'm making myself clear, anyone is confused, any questions anyone wants to ask? Because it's been silent for quite a while now, so I'm scared. Yeah, so that is the value of chaos. Hey, thanks, Pratik. Thanks, Tanmay.
You have?
There's one more command which is also very helpful. It's called repeat. You say repeat 5. And what happens in Midjourney? Midjourney works on very random algorithm. Every time you put a prompt, it generates something. Every time you put same prompt, it'll generate different set of images. No matter who's putting, how are you putting, or you know, if it's in your library, not in your library, if it's in database, not in database. If I'm using the same prompt again, it's going to give me a different set of 4 images. That most of the time works in our favor because you get to see new options and you get to brainstorm faster. So it's a wooden chair in Montreal style. It's a colorful 3D repeat 5. So it will repeat this prompt 5 times and give you 20 results. It will ask you before it do so.
That is
the run same prompt for 5 times. So you don't have to copy paste the same thing every time. The thing I would like to show you guys this document that I've been creating. I was thinking whether to show it here or not, because I'll be working on it for 3 more days before I put it on LinkedIn. I'm taking one prompt and putting it across multiple platforms and seeing what it generates. I'm using at least 12 text to image platforms, putting it in all 12 platforms with different models and different samplers. So this is the prompt that I've used. Ancient Indian art style features futuristic palace. This photorealistic landscape and structures with sharp focus and attention to detail. Now that's the prompt I have. I put it on Stable Diffusion on Discord, which is Stable Diffusion XM. This is the result I got. Same prompt on Playground with PNDM sampler. Same prompt on Playground using K-Euler sampler. You see the difference. Same platform, sampler is different. Playground using K-Euler ancestor, different image. It's just very fascinating to see how this differently trained models actually work on same prompt. It's the same prompt, just one prompt everywhere, different image.
Tapan, a quick question. What is a sampler? Yeah, Siddharth also has a very similar question.
Okay. Technically I'll be struggling a bit to explain what is sampler technically, but for my understanding, sampler is a way AI is being trained for a particular task. So different sampler will understand depth differently, shapes differently. Now what LMS really stands for, I do not know what LMS stands for. But then every sampler is for different. Now I'm working with this company called Hexo.ai. I'm a consultant with them. I'm a creative consultant with Hexo. They're building a Gen AI product for photo shoots. What they're doing is they're trying to sort of replace product photography. They're creating a tool where you can just put a product and it will generate the surrounding for you. It will generate product photography backgrounds for you. We are experimenting with different samplers. We have still not 100% understood these samplers, but then each time the sampler changes, it understands depth differently. If I have to put a water bottle on a bed, or if I have to put a water bottle on a beach, different samplers understand depth differently. So again, it's a lot of trial and error for me. So that's what I'm trying to create this document for. Okay, Dattaraj has pulled out the information. It's called Learning Management System. Okay. Thank you, Dattaraj, for pulling out this information for us. I'm quickly going to surf through all the slides. So again, playground, different sampler. This is Night Cafe, SDXL09. This is Night Cafe SD2.1. Same prompt, exactly same prompt. This is Midjourney 5.2. Lexica with V3 aperture. Lexica with V2 aperture. This is Deep AI. This is Desgo. Desgo is actually very nice. I recently found Desgo. Really nice free tool and mostly trained on anime dataset. So this model is called Anything 3.0 Anime. The sampler is DDIM. DDIM is a very popular sampler they use in stable diffusion. This is Desco again. Okay. We have to add more to this. I'll at least take 3 to 4 more days. Hello? Yes, someone is trying to speak.
Yeah, I'm Darshan this side. So I just wanted to ask if, say for example, if one image is generated, and if I just want to make some modification, so will that be possible?
Yes, in Midjourney, it's possible to an extent. In stable diffusion, they'll give you much more.
No, I'm asking in general, in terms of all the AI tools, like, is it possible to modify any kind of image that is generated? I guess, like, I tried a few tools and what I experienced was there is only one option to regenerate. And when it says regenerate, it completely creates a new image, new option, which is not similar to the one which is shown to you earlier.
Okay. We'll do that. Thank you. So now in Midjourney, are you familiar with Midjourney, Darshan?
Can you repeat it?
Are you familiar with Midjourney?
Yes, I have used the application once or twice. I have, generated a few results. But yes, this was a problem that I couldn't modify it to an extent. Like, I got a result, but how do I use it to my good use? Yeah.
Okay. Keep a close eye here. So whenever you go to Midjourney next, you go to setting. You first say / and setting. So it's going to give you the settings here. Then you go to remix mode. You switch it on. You switch the remix mode on. Then you write your prompt. We'll just say in this case, we'll say say a girl wearing a yellow hat. We'll keep it simple. Okay. I think I'll pick second because the head looks interesting. Let's say I upscale second. Now I go to variation. Very subtle. Here, the remix mode was activated. I see a girl wearing a red hat. Okay, surprisingly it worked. My bad. Okay, it's somewhat, I think the third is somewhat closer. It's not 100% though, but somewhat closer. So the remix mode actually allows you to do modification in your current image. Not 100%, like stable diffusion gives you more control over an existing image than Midjourney. Is this what you were looking for, Darshan? Or we should have one more demo?
Somewhat. I mean, like, to be very specific, like, say, for example, I'm creating something very professional, okay? And just like any other software, can I have an accurate result? Like, say, for example, I just want to precisely remove this yellow cap and change it with some other color. Just giving an example, like you've taken this image. So will it be actually precise? So here I can see in the second image, it has a little bit of gradient. So there is both a mixture of red and yellow, right? So can we achieve 100% accuracy, or will there be some, you know, 1 or 2% here and there?
No, I think more than 2%. In I have observed 10 to 20%, you know, variation. So accuracy is very important.
Okay.
Prompt weight can give you. Have you experimented with prompt weight?
No, not so far.
Okay, so that might help you. Again, I cannot take a guarantee, but maybe. So let's say a girl wearing a red hat.
Okay.
Now, if you just okay, so after this, you have to put double dots, and you give a you give weight to the entire thing. Now I'm not trying to change the color of the hat. I'm trying to create something different. So a girl wearing red hat has given weight 2. Now let's say floral background. Let me say floral here. Okay. Let's do 50. think this will be a better demo, the second one. So I've written a girl wearing a red hat sitting on a chair. Now I've not given any weight to any part of the prompt. I'm just going to hit enter without any weight. Now here I'm going to give.
So yeah, I just remembered. So there Adobe has just launched Adobe Firefly, right? So that tool is such that you can just put in the prompt, and as well as you'll have a few tools to edit and like play around with that image. So I think what I was trying to ask was, so here you get the result, and if you want some changes, you'll again have to edit the prompt itself.
Yes. So there's one way where you can get 100% result out of Midjourney. The other is you achieve 50-60% out of Midjourney and do rest 50% with
personalized tools.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you're saying a girl wearing a red hat sitting on a chair. Now,
okay.
You want to put a weight to it.
And also, so in the app which Midjourney has created, it has only, I think, about 5 tries for every day for a free user, right? So is the Midjourney like the PC version or the laptop version, is it free or is it paid?
So Midjourney is paid. Midjourney will give you some 5 to 10 in the beginning, but I think that also it has stopped giving now. It's paid now. You can start with $10 a month.
Achha, okay.
I think after 10, they have $30, $30, $50, and so on. It is paid for now, yes.
Okay. So are there any free tools which can which give a good result as well?
I think I'll the free ones here. Night Cafe is free. A couple of images you will get free in Night Cafe. Desgo is absolutely free. You can try Desgo. It's actually very nice.
Okay.
Like Desgo.
No, I'm hearing this for the first time.
Yeah, Desgo is nice. There's also Wombo. I personally don't like the result in Wombo, but you can try. Stable Diffusion Excel on Discord is absolutely free. I can send you an invite on Discord server.
But Discord is a little difficult to understand. I mean, I still have not understood how that works exactly.
It will just take probably a day or two to understand. It's not really that difficult. You just need to understand how the server actually works. It's not really difficult. Once you are on the Stable Diffusion server, it's super easy. There are a lot of channels where people are ready to help you always. Like I've learned a lot through those community chats on Discord, because not everything you will get answer on ChatGPT or Google.
Okay.
Discord communities are, I would say personally, better than even YouTube videos to learn. YouTube videos are nice. But there are so many videos on YouTube, you are going to get lost in learning exactly what you want. But if you go to Discord community and you ask a question, everyone is absolutely ready 24/7 to help you. They always help. We all help each other on Discord. So come to the brighter side.
Okay. Okay. What about Dall-E? It's Dall-E, right? Yeah. So I think Dall-E, what I have heard so far, like even on Instagram, that I think that's used mostly for marketing, right? Marketing and also for other content creators. So Dall-E is like very, very business oriented a tool, is it?
Not really. Just because it's owned by OpenAI, there's a lot of marketing been done for Dall-E. Because OpenAI definitely is more popular than I mean, OpenAI as a company is more popular, it's bigger. So a lot of marketing has been done, but personally, I've never really liked Dall-E's output. See, there are a couple of commercial projects people have pulled off using Dall-E, like someone like Karen Exchange. You would have seen Karen Chang's.
Karen, yes.
Chang, Karen Chang, then Paul Trillo. You would have seen Paul Trillo's work. So they both have done a lot of good thing using Dall-E, but then there are, you know, out of 100, you would see only 4 or 5 people generating good images using Dall-E. Dall-E, one, very expensive. Second, I personally don't like Dall-E's UI, because Dall-E interface is not as comfortable as Discord or Stable Diffusion is a bit more complex, but Discord UI is more user friendly than Dall-E. Also, Dall-E doesn't really give you control.
So okay.
Dall-E is very artistic. Dall-E, the only part where Dall-E is winning is in painting, out painting, because Dall-E introduced those concepts to the world. The concept of in painting and out painting, which was not, which didn't used to exist earlier. So that's a big credit I think we'll have to give to Dall-E for introducing in painting, out painting. Apart from that, the data set they are using is not really impressive. It's also not very refined. You know, you'll not see detailed images out of Dall-E.
Okay.
I just show something that I created for Baskin Robbins. Baskin Robbins India project is one of my milestone project in generative AI. I created these images using 100% Midjourney.
It's an excellent image.
Sorry?
This is an excellent output. I mean, I am a content creator myself. So like there is a lot of effort going to go if you're going to have a team, create this kind of an output.
There was a fun experiment, a fun project with basketball. So you see this level of, and this was Midjourney 4. After that it was 5, then 5.0. No, sorry, this was Midjourney 5. When I worked on this project, they had 5. Uske baad to 5.1 aa gaya. Now we have 5.2. So now if I have to work on this, it would be much more beautiful. Let's check this out. Like this.
So how long of a prompt did you write to create this kind of an output?
11 lines.
11?
Lines. 11 lines of prompt. So
can you just show me an example, like to create such a piece of art, can you just show an example, just type something that long if you can.
Okay, there's just one more insight I'll give. When brands work with you, they buy prompts. They don't allow you to show the prompt or give it to anyone. They just buy, they pay extra money to buy prompts. So that
Because I really face difficulties to, I want to create such things, but I just fail to create such prompts, and the result is far more, very different from what I have planned.
This is actually a very long discussion, because if I give you prompt, you copy paste the prompt, you get the image, but that's not the learning.
Okay.
You hit the ceiling there. As a content creator, you don't wish to hit the ceiling, you wish to learn. So rather than just understanding the prompt, I think the better understanding is to understand how prompt works. Then you can create your own 11, 12 or 5 lines of prompt. So it's not always like this. I say this to a lot of people when they say ki aap aapka prompt share karoge. Yeah, for the matter, anyone asking anyone on the internet that show me your prompt, it really doesn't work that way. If you are taking someone's prompt, or if I am taking someone's prompt and I'm just copy pasting it and creating that image, then I'm just killing my creativity. I'm just, because the more you will do trial and error, there is definitely 100% possibility you will create better images than me. Probably I will be learning from you after a few months. Because their algorithm keeps evolving. Like the reason I had such a long prompt is because Midjourney didn't used to understand shorter prompts. Like how we created this chair image here, the one we are seeing here, I just wrote a wooden chair. Now, while creating this, I was talking to Pratik and I said that a few months back to create this, it would have taken me like at least 8 to 10 different words. But now it is way easier. So as these models are evolving, it's getting increasingly easier to achieve more fancy images. So, that's what I have to say. Like, I see, I'm going to show you the images that I finally delivered to Baskin Robbins that are there on their social media. This is their blueberry and white chocolate. All these are 100% Midjourney. So definitely a lot of trial error, a lot of tools, but then my target was to achieve something 100% out of Midjourney. I didn't really want to go to any other software. There was no such brief from client ki aapko 100% AI generated karna hai. They said that you can do, but then it was a challenge that I gave to myself that I'm going to create something 100% generated. Because in that process, I actually learned a lot. If I would have given myself that leverage, ki haan theek hai 50-60 yahan se kar lete, rest we will figure in Photoshop. I would not have learned how to write good prompt. I'll just take this to, let's say we take this to Photoshop. You were asking about Firefly, right, Darshan?
Yes sir. Yeah,
so this is the new Photoshop beta. It has Adobe Firefly in it, the generative film. So let's say I take this, and if I want to create a coffee bean here, then I'll just draw this here. I'll say coffee bean. Okay, I got a coffee bean, but not really beautiful looking coffee bean. There's one more option, the third option. I think this looks okay. Or this one, I think this looks better. Have you used Photoshop with Firefly? Has anyone used Photoshop with Firefly?
I have, since I do not have the paid version of Photoshop, so I used the Firefly from the website itself. So I just, you know, took an image and generated various backgrounds for that image. So basically, like I do product photography. So at times you need to be very, you know, skillful enough to do product manipulation, photo manipulation, right? So that thing is just being generated on a click. So it's just, you just have to cut that image out, and you know, you place it there, and even the shadows, lighting, everything is done for you.
Correct.
So it's an interesting thing.
You might want to go for this Photoshop beta. It's really helpful. It's really helpful, very, very fast, very powerful. Like, I just created this coffee bean. If I want to create milk splash somewhere here, let's see, and then I'll just draw this, and I'll just say milk splash. Okay, I think this looks a little bit better. We can have, select this base, we can have a few more, something like this. Make a splash. It actually took reference from the splashes at the top.
Yeah, this is what I was talking about. I mean, I think this is far more better than all the tools that are, you know, generating the images.
Yeah, this is more towards functional side, and the others are more towards formal. So the other tools are like to create art, and this is for branding, marketing. Like this, these are the, I mean, Photoshop generative fill is for business. I mean, to create images that you can sell to brands, whether Midjourney or pure Midjourney is just art which you can sell as an art and frame it, put it up on wall as an art piece. And the good thing here is you get everything on different layer. This coffee bean is on different layer. This milk splash is on different layer. This particular milk splash is on different layer. You can always switch off and you can create one more splash. If you don't want the entire thing now, if you select this, it moves with the background. So you can get rid of that also. You can just rasterize it. Okay. And then you can select subject. And you can separate it from the background. Yeah. Okay.
Just a mask can be created and.
So it's very, very, very helpful. You might really want to go for this. The one I have is the, I think it's some 750 a month subscription. I think there are two, three. There's one which 1200 or 1500, but just the 700 or 750 a month would give you these tools. You don't really have to, because Adobe will always try to sell you the higher product, the higher range. You don't really have to go for those. The 700 a month will give you these tools. You can really try it out.
Okay. However, which the images that they generate, some images are like practically very impossible to have or visualize, but the AI just creates it in such a way that, yeah, it seems like this kind of an ice cream can literally exist.
Yeah. That's the magic. So my takeaway from this technology or this tool, and my takeaway and my selling point, like how I talk to my client, is if they have to achieve this photo shoot in real, how much it would cost, how much food they will waste. And
very, very, it's a very, very expensive shoot if you want to do something like this. I have done something like this and I know for a reason. It's rather actually to create something like that is something else. And the BTS that happens, the behind the scenes that happens, is more nastier actually. Yeah. The splashes around the wall and the things it hit.
Yeah. The entire mess after the shoot, you probably need more than two spot boys to clean the mess.
Right.
So, but then that's the thing. Like it's going to save a lot of food wastage. At the same time, it has a potential to take away more than 5 to 6 jobs that are currently existing on set. There are light men. There are light men who get paid, you know, 15,000 to 20,000 a day just to hold the lights or reflector. They are going to lose their jobs. There's a food photographer. There's a food stylist. I paid more than 60,000-70,000 a day
for
a food stylist. So I right. I can save up there. I've paid more than 4.5 lakh to food photographer who also knows food styling. There are light men, there are spot boys, there's a studio you have to rent. It's so much of expense that goes behind photo shoot. While I created these 5 images for Baskin Robbins just myself sitting in a room on a computer on a chair.
Right. So, yeah. I think it's like for those companies who are just starting up and are thinking that, yeah, I need a 3D rendered image, which should look something like this, instead of hiring a 3D artist who needs to get paid in lakhs, rather this is just like get a subscription of a few dollars and get this done. But I think it's about prompting rather. I think somebody can make money just by writing a book on prompting and selling it out.
Thanks. I would like to do that.
I think we can do it in collaboration. The idea was mine.
Definitely. Call me after this call.
Thank you. Thank you, Darshan, for those exciting inputs. Thank you, Tapan, for actually walking us through these questions. Fantastic. Like, my mind personally is blown so far.
Thank you.
Same here, same.
I think we are out of time, running out of time. Now, what do you want me to do next? How are we summing this up?
We can actually just open things up for if there are any more questions. I think Darshan was kind enough to ask a lot of intriguing questions, and noobs like us were also there, like, who asked a lot of questions. If there are any other questions, please put them on chat. Meanwhile, I'll hand it over to Harshit sir as well to bring the session to a conclusion. While if there are no other questions, then.
No, I think the interesting bit was it was, as it is, very interactive, where a lot of questions were coming in, and Tapan kind of weaved that into the discussion itself. So I think we are good on the Q&A part. And as it is, I think if there are any more questions, you all can always reach out to us, and we can get it answered by Tapan. And this is an ongoing initiative, so I think this is one of the sessions, and we'll be having more sessions around the similar topics in the future as well. So keep your questions coming in, keep writing to us, keep reaching out to us in case you need to know anything more about generative AI or design in general. So yeah, that's a very kind of a interesting and a fantastic way to get this kind of discussion going on. Tapan, you have anything more to share?
I think my only slide which is left is this ethics and copyright. Now, AI ethics is definitely a very long discussion. I would just like to show this video for everyone to understand that how easier it has become to manipulate people, how easier it has become to tweak or alter videos. That the tools that have been used are free for now. Even though they'll be paid, it's not going to be very expensive for people to actually get subscription and create altered video. So the first one is Leonardo DiCaprio addressing the UN. And I think I would not say anything. I'll just play the video for everyone to see.
Hundreds of thousands of people who marched in the streets of New York on Sunday.
And the billions of others around the world who want to solve our climate crisis.
As an actor, I pretend for a living. I play fictitious characters, often solving fictitious problems.
I believe that mankind has looked at climate change in that same way, as if it were fiction.
As if pretending that climate change wasn't real would somehow make it go away. But I think we all know better than that now.
Hundreds of thousands of people who marched in the streets of New York on Sunday.
And the billions of others around the world who want to solve our climate.
So a part of this speech has been trained on Steve Jobs' voice, a part of on Robert Downey Jr.'s voice, a part on Kim Kardashian's voice, and so seamlessly fitting a single video. The second I have is Barack Obama.
We're entering an era which our enemies can make it look like anyone is saying anything at any point in time.
Jordan Peele created this fake video of President Obama.
Sorry.
We're entering an era which our enemies can make it look like anyone is saying anything at any point in time.
Jordan Peele created this fake video of President Obama to demonstrate how easy it is to put words in someone else's mouth.
Moving forward, we need to be more vigilant with what we trust from the internet.
Not everyone bought it, but the technology behind such frauds is rapidly improving, even as worries increase about their potential for harm. This is your Bloomberg quick take on deepfakes. Deepfakes, or realistic-looking fake videos and audio, gained popularity as a means of adding famous actresses into porn scenes. Despite bans on major websites, they remain easy to make and find. They're named for the deep learning artificial intelligence algorithms that make them possible. Input real audio or video of a specific person, the more the better, and the software tries to recognize patterns in speech and movement. introduce a new element like someone else's face or voice, and a deep fake is born.
It's actually extremely easy to make one of these things. There were just some supposed, you know, breakthroughs from academic researchers who work with this particular kind of machine learning in the past few weeks, which would drastically reduce the amount of video you need actually to create one.
Programs like FakeM, the most popular and widely available for making deep fakes, need dozens of hours of human assistance to create a video that looks like this rather than this. In August, researchers at Carnegie Mellon revealed software that accurately rendered not just facial features, but changing weather patterns and flowers in bloom. This advance is not yet available to the public, but with increasing capability comes increasing concern.
You know, this is kind of fake news on steroids, potentially. We do not know of a case yet where someone has tried to use this to...
It's quite a long video, but so I always promote ethical use of AI. I always tell people to not mention living artists' name in the prompt. We all know how AI is capable of replicating someone's artwork, because whenever we have bought new phone or new computer, whenever we have logged into a new account, there's a long disclaimer of 10, 20, 30 page, and we just say agree, agree, agree. We all have been clicking on agree for almost 10, 15 years. We agreed to let our data out in the public. A lot of these platforms, they pick this data. All these models are trained on our data set. We only gave consent. So a lot of artists who actually struggled to make their name, to make their way in artistic industry, art industry, their work is on Behance, their work is on Google, their work is everywhere. That's also being flicked to create these images. When people say create a painting like Pablo Picasso, I think that's not an issue, because Picasso is not here to give consent, or Picasso is not currently earning any money out of his artwork. Whoever is earning money out of Picasso's artwork are very different kind of people. But someone who is alive and trying to make a living out of his or her work really don't deserve to get his or her work flicked by someone just mentioning their name in the prompt. So whenever you are creating a prompt for your artwork, try not to use any living artist's name in it. That's one way to start understanding the ethical use of AI. Definitely AI ethics is much more than creating image. It goes way deeper than this. But talking about art, this is one point I wanted to share. And copyright, definitely in India, currently Indian government is giving copyright to AI-generated work. A lot of countries are not giving this permission. In India, luckily, AI-generated images can get copyrighted.
Using chat,
anyone wants to ask any question about copyright, you can reach out to me post-session, or you can ask Harshit sir or Pratik about my contact or anything. They will take these questions. So I think this is just what I wanted to share on the ending note.
Right. But definitely, I think a very important point and a good ending note, I would say, because that's an area which will require a separate session altogether. And that's what everybody is putting their kind of minds and efforts on. How do we kind of really manage ethics and all these things? Because this is so unprecedented, right? Means we never have faced these kind of tools and situations, and that too with so much of speed. Means every day something new comes up and it kind of challenges whatever was existing. So definitely, I think that yesterday's newspaper had that they are trying to put a regulator for everything around AI and all of that. So I think there's a lot of work happening at different levels on this. But yeah, I think in whatever framework that we are currently working, and the kind of things which are possible to be done within the boundaries of maintaining the ethics and the right kind of credits to be given to the people involved. You have been doing an amazing job, Tapan. So thanks for all the time and sharing your journey. And I'm sure there are a lot of takeaways for everybody at different points. And we would like to see more of this, and best of luck for the fantastic work that you are doing as it is, and we'll keep hearing more good news about you from the press as well.
thank you so much, sir. Really glad to be here, and I really hope people could learn something out of this session. Thank you.
Sure. Okay.
Thank you very much, Tapan.
Yes.
Thank you very much, everyone. Please, we've shared the Build Hackathons link. Make sure you're signing up for the hackathon. That's next Sunday. It's an online event. Please be present, and we'll have lots of fun building some really interesting solutions using artificial intelligence. Maybe you can pick something up from Midjourney and from a lot of prompts and how to use this technology, what Tapan told us, in your builds next week. So see you all at the event. Take care. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thanks, Tapan. Thanks, Pratik, Tanmay, everybody. Thanks for being.
Thank you, sir. Good night. Take care.
Good night.